My name is Koen van Oostrom. Good afternoon. I founded the company, a real estate technology company, and that's my second company. My first company was an actual real estate company, and the buildings that you see here are the kind of buildings that my company used to make. Typical real estate. We worked with famous architects like, in this case, Rem Koolhaas, and we did all kinds of buildings. 10 years ago, something big happened. I met this guy. I met him again just now inside here, but 10 years ago I met him. And he was in the Netherlands to promote his book and to talk about sustainability. And he organized a round table with people from the business. And he said, guys, we can wait for the government, we can wait for NGOs, but ultimately it's going to be the businesses that will be the drivers for change. And I talked to him and he said, actually, the real estate industry is a big part of the problem, so you have to do something about it. And we got together with a whole group of people and we said, okay, maybe we should make more sustainable buildings. Let's figure out how to do this. And the really crazy thing was it was so relatively easy. It was relatively easy to disrupt that big real estate industry. And so we started to work and we made a building and we made a building that was energy neutral. And then we made a second building and ultimately we made this building. And this building was a building called The Edge. And there was a big tenant, Deloitte, and Deloitte reached out to us and say, can you help us to make a building that is really a game changer, really disruptive for the industry, because we want to have something that really pushed the boundaries of sustainability. And we started to work at it, and we put our best people together. And we figured out, if you really want to make a sustainable building, the trick is to put thousands and thousands of sensors in a building. And if you really know exactly what is happening in that building, then you can be way more precise in the way you organize your energy or the way you organize where the people work, etc. And that's what we did here. Now, I think it's interesting to look at the real estate industry for a second. The real estate industry has something amazing. And the amazing thing is it's actually the largest industry in the world. It's in terms of percentage of GDP, by far bigger than any other industry. There's also a downside to the real estate industry, and that is that there hardly has been any productivity growth over the last 20 years, or for that matter, for the last 70 years. If you look how long it takes to develop a building and to build a building, let's say that the design process takes us about 1 to 2 years, and before World War II, it was also between 1 and 2 years. So nothing has changed in that industry, which, as an entrepreneur, I find an amazing opportunity. Now, we start to think, and we said, there's actually two problems that we need to solve in the real estate industry. The first problem is sustainability. There's really something we need to do, and we have to make sure that no more buildings that are newly built need energy, and we need to make sure that existing buildings are completely redefined and start to use a lot less energy than in the past. And the second problem we have is that people like yourself don't want to work anymore in a traditional office building. Why would you? There's so many more fun places to go to. It's very often more fun to be in a Starbucks than it is to be in a typical office building. And so we have to start to make buildings that are ready for the generations that are coming. And all these buildings from the past, we have to redevelop them and make them a lot better. You see a building here on the left that is an example of these old buildings. And on the right, you see actually my team in Amsterdam, and they're very happy to be working in a building like that. So we figured out that we had to stop being a real estate company, because then it would be difficult to disrupt anything, redefine ourselves, and make sure that we would become a company that could really do things in a very different way. We were thinking about productizing. We were thinking about what can you do with IoT solutions. What can we learn from all these other things that are happening in the technology world? And so we closed our eyes and we said, what is now actually the perfect building that we could make? And we're actually building a building at the moment. This is a building in Amsterdam. It's not completely an office building. It's a mix of different functions. For us, this is a little bit a metaphor of this new kind of buildings that we want to make. And it has four elements, these new buildings. The first thing is sustainability. I talked about that. The second thing is health. We have to make buildings that are very healthy. The third is make amazing design. And the fourth is connect all the dots with the smart technology. So talking about sustainability, I said it already. there is no reason anymore for any newly built building now not to be energy neutral. There's really no reason for it. The technology is there, the money is there. We just need leadership to get it going. Existing buildings, a little bit harder, but also there. There's a lot we can do without really changing the numbers. We can just learn from existing operations and reduce the costs that people are making in the energy bill and invest that money in the operation. So the second thing is health. What is more beautiful than having people going into a building, leaving in the evening, and in the meantime, the real target that we have is that they come out of the building in the evening healthier than they came in the morning. How do we do that? Basically by measuring exactly what is happening in that building. On a workplace level, we want to make sure that we can understand how warm is it, how much light is there, can we add different kinds of light, maybe blue light when you're tired. There's a lot of technologies out there that can help us to make things more healthy. Very simple thing as well, a big staircase instead of the place where normally the elevators would be, really helps us to take the staircases off there. And so there's a lot of design features there as well. The third thing that we want to do is make sure that our buildings have an amazing design. And it's not so difficult, but you want to be working in the building where if you walk in and you see the lounge, that you don't even want to go to your floor anymore. You don't even want to, you know, pick up your bag, go in the elevator, go up or take the staircase. You just want to sit there. You want to have amazing coffee. You want to open your computer and you want to do your work exactly where you are. The fourth part is the technology. And this is what we've learned from this first edge building that we did together with Deloitte. If you have all these sensors and you have all this knowledge of what people are doing in the building, it turns out that it's possible that the efficiency of the building really goes up. It is possible to make sure that people get rid of all these annoying things that take time, like room booking, like waiting at the desk and when you have to check into a new office building. All these things can be done in a way, simpler way. And we now found out with 3 years of data exactly how to do that. We got all these things together, and we just finished a building in the United States. We did a building for Unilever, and Unilever had actually an existing building. Existing buildings, a little bit harder than a new build, but also here we plugged in all these different things, made sure that the building became healthy, 40% less carbon emissions. However, with 50% more people working in that building. And so the emissions per person are really made an amazing step. Typical for American existing buildings, built in the 70s, single pane glass, and a lot of machines that are pumping heat and coolness in the area. All that is over, and it's now possible to make buildings that are actually more sustainable and a lot more happier to work in. So a few numbers about the company. We have already made 1 million square meters of office buildings. We have a pipeline of 2.5 billion. And so we are really ready to jump and become way more, even than today, an international company. What is our plan for the next period? First, we enjoy that we have an amazing team together. We have big offices in Amsterdam, Berlin, and New York, and smaller offices in other places. We just raised $1.2 billion in a fund that is buying our real estate. That part of money is more or less used with all the new acquisitions that we've done. And so now we're raising more money to grow the business more. We have an open, innovative ecosystem around us. And we have a lot of partners. And this is why I'm happy to be here in Berlin today, because these partnerships are for us the most important thing. Some of the big companies like Siemens and Schneider Electric turn out to have a lot of innovation ready to go into the real estate industry. But there's also a lot of startups that connect to us and that tell us, hey, we have this technology, we want to work with you, and we want to go on. We have a mission to make 1,000 buildings. It's a little bit of a moonshot, 1,000 amazing buildings in the big cities in the world. And I hope that we can reach out to you and work together with some of your companies to get that going. Thank you so much.